The new and approved Google Calendar has been out for a little while now, but I wanted to take a few moments and highlight some of my favorite features as a part of the calendar redesign. Now, if you're already using Google Calendar on your smartphone or on your tablet, a lot of these changes probably look familiar to you. That's because the very same UI, the color scheme, the fonts, the responsive design have all carried over from those previous mobile versions of the Google Calendar. But there are a few other additional differences when you're working with the desktop version of Google Calendar. So let's take a look at some of the things that I really appreciate, some of the things that I love about the new update. The first one has to do with not needing to open up the edit view of an event to see additional details. So you may recall in the previous Google Calendar, if I wanted to see the details of this meeting, I would have to click on it and then it would open up full screen the full edit mode of that event. Well, now with just a single click, I can get all of those details here in a much smaller dialog. I still get all the information that I want to look at. I can click on these links. I can see who's attending. I can even change my status, but I don't need to go into this view. I don't need to go into the full edit view anymore. So I'm really appreciating this preview view as I'm browsing my calendar if I want a little more information and see those details here. Now let's stick with this preview view for just a few more moments. Another thing that's been added is that you can hover over your attendees and get additional contact information. Previously, you would only see the name and possibly the email address, but now when I hover over, I can see their phone number, I can see their title, anything else that I've added to their contact card, I can see it at a glance, which has made it so much easier as I'm about to call someone or about to join a meeting. I don't need to open up the full-blown edit mode. I don't need to go somewhere else to retrieve their information or remember, hey, what is their title at this particular company? Now, if we do go into edit mode, there's another big enhancement as you are creating or editing your events, and that is that we now have some rich formatting within the description area. You may recall in the previous Google Calendar that this was purely a text-based area. Now, links would work, but you would have to paste the original URL. You'd have to paste the original link here, which was often very long and very ugly looking. Now, we can take a complex link such as this or a longer link, and then we can format it so it makes a lot more sense for the people who are joining this meeting, who are going to log into this video conference. You may also notice that, you know, I've added some bolding here to this first line, whether it's an italicizing of your text, whether it's adding underline, we do have some additional rich text formatting available to us so we can punch up or make certain text stand out. And here's another way of using, you know, that link formatting. Here, maybe I have an agenda. Maybe this is linked to a Trello card or some other application. It can look nice and neat, November meeting items, and people can click on it and go directly to that agenda item. So really glad to see rich formatting here within the description area. Now, if I close down this edit view, there's another feature that's been added, and I particularly like this because most of us are managing multiple calendars, or maybe you're working with an organization and you have access to other team member calendars. So if we go up to the view dropdown, I'm in the week view right here, and if we select the day view, you now have the option of comparing two or more calendars side by side. So here you see I've got a personal calendar here on the left-hand side, and I've got my work calendar on the right-hand side. So I can compare, you know, what my schedule is like between these two calendars in the day view. And again, I can add multiple calendars. I can add other employees. I can add other clients that I may have access to their calendars and view them all in this day view. Now, I'm going to go back to the week view for just a moment because that's my preference. That's my preferred view. But I do want to share one other thing that I really appreciate, a new feature to the new Google Calendar. If we go up to the settings menu, you will see just below settings is something called trash. And trash is really an area very much like you would find in your email account, are all the events which you have deleted or remove. Now, these aren't things that have just expired that have happened in the past. These are things that you've actually deleted or removed. So maybe you've deleted something by mistake. You can come back here and restore it to your calendar. Maybe, like I have suggested in a previous Simpletivity video, maybe you're using your calendar as a partial to-do list. That's why you see a lot of tasks here. You can come back and review what are the tasks you've completed in the last 30 days. And yes, the trash will be eliminated after that 30-day period, but you can come back here and repurpose something or restore it to the calendar, or if you'd like, you can go ahead and empty the trash as well. But this is a new area where you can review things which you have removed from your calendar already. So, next up, I'd love to hear from you. What is your experience with the new Google Calendar? Do you like it, or do you prefer the classic version? Which one are you using right now? And is there something that I haven't highlighted here that you really like about the new Google Calendar? Thank you so much for watching today's video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. I'd love to hear from you in the comments, and be sure to subscribe right here to Simpletivity. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.